Now let's start. First, what we have done is we have created a class called calling. Okay, name of a class is calling. Then come to stat int num is equal to 6. Means this is an integer type variable num whose initial value will be 6. And here I have written stat means static. Stat. Why I have written this static? Because the static value means the variable is going to be common for all the object in the program. Okay, the variable will not change in whole program for an object. That's why it is static. Public static void main. This is a main function. Void main string this. Then we will write down system.out.println num is equal to plus num. Means we will print this first. What will we print it? We will print num. Means the value of this num is 6. 6 will be printed after this line. Next line. Now look at this number 6. What we have done. Number 5. What we have done is we have called by value. Okay. The function name called by value. Here you can write down anything, any name you can give. I have written call by value because it will be easier for you to understand. We can give other name also. Then we are calling the function num. Okay, we are calling the function num. This num will be called here. As soon as we call this num here, what happens is your program will directly go to this line number 11. Okay. Public stat void call by value int n. Okay, int n means the integer value, num value will be copied to this n. Okay, the value 6 will be copied to this n. N is equal to 36. Then the copied value will be changed to 36. Now, you listen very carefully. What happens is in call by value, the value will be changed, not the address. Understood? This is call by value. So we can change the value of n is equal to 36. What happens is, while printing this, your value will be 6 because you are printing the initial value. But printing, while printing this, what happens here? Value will be changed to n is equal to 36. The copied value will be changed, not the actual value. The actual value remains the same. The copied value will be changed. Now, another question arises. How do we know the difference between call by value and call by reference? In call by value, the primitive data types are used. Wherever in your program the primitive data type is used, like int is a primitive data type. As you have already learned in your previous class, that is in class 9, about primitive data type. Okay, there are total 8 primitive data type in your Java programming language. Out of that 8, int is one kind of primitive data type. Understood? If your program is using primitive data type and calling it in middle of a program means it is call by value. But what happens in call by reference is the data type are non-primitive. Okay, if the data types are non-primitive, not out of that 8 data type, then it will be call by reference. Now look at this number 7. Line number 7. Calling object is equal to new calling means now we have called an object inside the class calling. The object is made or created inside the class calling. This is a syntax for making an object inside a class. Okay, we have made an object obj is equal to new calling. Then we are calling another function, that is call by reference. Okay, you can write down another name for understanding purpose. I have written call by reference here as I have written call by value. So it will be understable for you. Okay, we are calling another function call by reference obj. This object will be called here. The object of class calling will be called in call by reference. Understood? If a value is not a primitive data type, like obj is not a primitive data type, it is not defined, means it is called by reference. Understood? Int is primitive data type, it is called by value. Obj is not a primitive, it is called by, then we will do, it will follow. If it is non-primitive, then it will follow called by reference mechanism. Next, as soon as you will call this function call by reference obj, your program will straight away go to this public stat void call by reference calling ob. This what happens is the object we have passed over here will be received by this variable calling ob. Okay, now come to line number 15. ob.num is equal to 36, means the num variable inside this object. Okay, inside this object, the num variable, whatever we have, will be changed to 36. Since it is non-primitive data type, the object, the variable of the num within this object will be changed to 36. The original value of the object or num variable inside this object will be changed to 36. But in call by value, what we have seen is only the copied portion will be changed. Actual remains the same. But in call by reference, whatever we have inside the object, whatever num variable we have inside the object will be changed to 36. The actual value will be changed. So at last, we will look at the output of the program. First, num is equal to 6. Okay, look at this line number 4. System.out.println num is equal to plus n, means num is equal to 6. This 6 will be printed. This is an output for this statement. Second one is num after call by value. Okay, look at this number 6, line number 6. System.out.println num after call by value. After call by value also the num remains same. Okay, actual value of this num remains same. It is unchangeable. It will not change. Only here it will be changed. Understood? Call by value. But here whenever you are printing it will be same. It is static. It is actual value, so it will not change. Last one is num after call by reference. Now look at this number 9. After call by reference, as I have already told you, the variable inside the object will be changed, means it has been changed to 36. Okay, the variable num inside the object is changed to 36. So output we are getting here is num after call by reference is equal to 36.